Hi, hello, welcome to Easy Classes. Guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to speed up your Windows operating system at least 10 times more. That is, we can easily do that in 5 minutes. Let me show you how. Before jumping to the tutorial, I request you to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is how you can support me. Guys, without further ado, let's get started. As a first step, you have to disable the startup applications. To do that, right click on the taskbar and there you have to click on the task manager. And then on the startup tab, click on that. And here you can find that the startup applications will load on the boot time. So these are unnecessarily starting up on your Windows operating system. To disable them, right click on the application and hit disable. So make sure the unwanted applications to start up, that you have to disable. So once you've done that, you can find the status as disabled. So disable the all unnecessary applications and close the window. And guys, next up, we have to enable the high performance mode on your system. To do that, right click on the this PC and select properties. And in the right sidebar, you have to find advanced system settings. Click on that and then make sure you are on the advanced tab. There you will find performance. Under the performance, click on the settings button. And in the most cases, the Windows has default set to let Windows choose what's best for my computer. I suggest you to change for adjust for best performance. So I have selected adjust for best performance and apply and save okay. And okay and close the window. Guys, this will disable the all unnecessary animations and visual appearance. So that will save some memory on your RAM and it will speed up. Okay, let's move to the third method. That is, we have to add virtual memory on our system. To do that, go to the Windows search bar and search for advanced system settings. Open the app under best match result. And this time you have to select the settings under performance only. And there you have to select the advanced settings. And you may notice that the font is not appearing good. So after applying the best performance, in such cases, you can make some exception here. That is, by selecting the smooth edges of screen fonts, apply and then okay. So now the fonts are appearing good, and then select settings, then move to the advanced tab here under performance options. There you can find the virtual memory section. Click on the change. By default, it is selected to automatically manage for paging files, so you have to deselect it. So once you've done that, the options are available for different drives. So let's select the C drive, which is the operating system and softwares has installed. And if you come to the custom size, you can find two boxes are here, that is initial size and maximum size, that we have to put in megabytes. According to the Microsoft Windows has recommended, you have to put maximum 1.5 times of initial size of your memory and maximum size of 3 times compared to the original RAM size on your system. Let me give an example what I'm telling you. Let me open calculator and then you have to find what is the current RAM size on your system. So right click on the this PC or my computer, then hit properties. And there you can find the installed RAM size under device specifications. So find that the RAM size on your system. I'm using 16 GB. Close the window. And we have to calculate here. That is, 1 GB is equal to 1024 megabytes. And then multiply with your current RAM size. I'm using 16 GB of RAM. So I'm putting 16 here and I converted my RAM size into megabytes. And finally, multiply with 1.5 times. Guys, this is the value I have to put in the initial size. So let me copy that and paste here. You have to put numerical values only here. So let me remove the comma. And further, we have to calculate for maximum size. To do that, let me clear it. And again, start with 1024 MB into RAM size. That's I'm using 16 GB. And multiply with 3 times. So this is the maximum size I can use. Let me remove the cover here. And guys, we have done the calculations and filled the box. So this is how you have to calculate with your RAM size. So once you're done, hit set and say okay. Okay, and click OK. And close the window. So we have successfully added the virtual RAM size on our system. And guys, finally I will give you some bonus tips to remove the all junk files and temporary files on your system. That will definitely boost your system performance. So why do we wait? Let's get started. First, go to the Windows search bar and search for run. Open the run app and here you have to type temp and hit enter. So these are the temporary files has located in my system. Select the all files by hitting Ctrl plus A or select manually and right click, hit delete and hit continue. So some of the files we cannot delete because some of the applications are running in the background. So once you close them, you can delete this. So no worry, we can just skip. And then again, go to the Windows search bar and search for run. Open the run app and this time you have to enter percentage symbol temp percentage symbol and hit enter. Select the all files, right click and hit delete. You can see that in terms of GB, I'm deleting the temporary files. Do this for all current items and hit continue. Again, some applications files will be accepted here. Just do this for all and skip and close the window. And finally, again, open the run applications. And here you have to type prefetch, prefetch and hit OK. Say yes to continue. Again, select the all files by hitting Ctrl plus A button, right click and hit delete and close the window. And guys, finally we have a simple step that we have to do. Don't skip that because we have deleted the files from temporary location to recycle bin. So we have to empty the recycle bin. So open the recycle bin, click on the empty recycle bin and say yes and hit continue. Yes, we have successfully deleted the all files here. And that's it guys, this is how we can easily speed up your Windows 10 operating system at least 10 times more by using these methods. I hope this video helps you. If you found helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the bell icon. Well, I trust I will meet in the next video. Till then, bye bye.